Jerry.
What the hell is all this?
This is a mate of mine. That's Lorraine, and that's Gary. Looking for a place to stay for a couple of days. I mean, okay if we put up here?
Why not?
Like something to eat.
Would I ever?
Give me that gun.
No, Mr. Regan.
What the hell's this all about?
We know what you did.
What are you talking about?
Bam, bam, bam! We read newspapers. Sometimes.
Wasn't a very good picture of you.
Nice one of Des. What's it like to shoot someone?
Why don't you find out?
What's it feel like?
What the hell do you think this is, a bloody toy? Pow!
Looks like cappuccino.
Taste that counts.
Don't get beer in jail. Or women.
I'd rather have the grog.
Don't like women?
Oh, some of them are all right. My old man used to always say that women were like elephants.
Elephants?
Yeah. Good fun to look at, but real trouble around the house.
How'd you get mixed up with Des?
Oh, it's a long story. He's a silly young bastard, but he's all right. He just has to make things hard for himself.
Bet there's a lot you could teach him.
Hey. Have you met Walter? Do you know he's a fully qualified lawyer? They wouldn't recognize his qualifications out here. Isn't that stupid? That's why he's still in Cardiff.
No. The other reason is that their very beautiful daughter, Annie, whom I have the good fortune of knowing quite well, has just turned 21. You're the birthday girl, are you? Got a little present for you, girlie.
Cindy!
I need to get the house down, Dad.
Where did you get this?
One of the girls at the club gave it to me.
Well, you can give it right back. I won't have filth like this in the house.
Oh, Dad.
And look at the way you're dressed. What will people think?
Who's to see me? I'm not exactly standing in a department store window.
With my being a counsellor, you know very well that anyone can drop in at any time. So go and get something decent on. There's a good girl.
Oh, OK. Do you want some breakfast?
Lunch.
For you, it's lunch. For me, it's breakfast.
Well, if you get a proper job...
Now, Dad.
All right. But I don't want cereal for lunch.
One chicken sandwich coming up.
You're not going out dressed like that.
I'll wear my coat and it saves me changing.
Dancing like that in front of all those men, what would your mother think?
We both have a good idea what she'd think.
Is the job that good?
Oh, I like it.
But you have a university degree.
Yeah, Bachelor of Arts, dime a dozen. Anyway, go-go dancing's a form of art.
Well, I've been patient long enough for you to give it up.
See you in the morning, Dad.
Oh, it's early yet. Can't we just talk about it?
We have.
Come and have a drink with your old dad.
Okay, but no yelling or I go.
I promise.
You know, I think you're just a snob. You don't like your daughter being a go-go dancer.
That's not true. It's not you I'm worried about. It's other girls just like you.
You dirty old man.
Cindy, have you thought what happens to those men watching you?
I've got a pretty good idea.
Right. What happens when they leave the club?
Search me.
They go out and attack and rape other women.
Oh, now, Dad, that's not true. Some psychiatrists say that watching me is good for them, gets rid of inattention.
But how can you be sure? That woman I told you about, how do you know her attacker wasn't one of your customers?
Oh, you should be a lawyer. I'll think about it.
Good girl.
He's out the back doing some gardening. I'll get him.
We'd like to talk to you first.
Right.
It's about your mother.
Oh.
Do you know where she is?
No.
You reported her missing to Frankston Police Station a year ago.
That was a mistake. My mother left us. She went off with another man.
Now, why didn't you notify Frankston Police?
Dad got the letter. I thought he told them.
Did you read the letter?
I didn't want to.
Would you get your father?
I'm his daughter. The sergeant said I could see him. Hello, Dad.
Hello, darling. Constable, you haven't met my daughter. Isn't she beautiful? Now, have you considered what we discussed about your job?
That you've both given to Miss Francis, but there are still a number of questions we'd like to ask you.
Yes. Go ahead.
In your statement, you said at no time did you glimpse your assailant's face.
That's right. He grabbed me from behind. I didn't get a chance to see him.
I only saw him running away. He had his back to me.
Well, at least you were able to give us an approximate height and color of hair, but you didn't happen to notice what he was wearing?
Oh, not really. Jeans, a lightish shirt, I think.
Mrs. Carter, you attend these yoga classes every Monday?
Oh, yes, I've been going for about 4 months now.
And your husband usually picks you up at the same time?
Yes.
Did you pick your wife up at the usual time yesterday, Mr. Carter?
No, a good deal earlier. Thank God.
Oh, yes, he's usually about 15 minutes late.
I just happened to finish early. Hmm.
Then it seems apparent that your assailant was familiar with your movements on Mondays, Mrs. Carter.
You mean he picked me up before her?
I say so. It was obvious you were waiting for someone, but that didn't deter him. He must have felt confident that he had the time to do what he wanted to do.
He could have only known that, Mrs. Carter, if he knew what time your husband usually picked you up.
Why, Leon? I mean, there's hundreds of girls in that neighborhood.
Mrs. Carter, do you know of anyone who would want to kill you?
No. No one.
Someone from your past? An old boyfriend?
Paul was my only boyfriend.
We married when she was 17.
Think back, Mrs. Carter. Has anyone ever threatened you in any way?
Mrs. Carter?
No, no one.
It doesn't matter how long ago.
I told you, no.
Look, I'd like to get her home, if you don't mind, please.
Just one more question, Mrs. Carter. Did you ever know a girl named Louise Morgan?
No. No, I've never heard of Louise Morgan. Please, Paul, I want to go home.
Mrs. Carter, that's it. But if you do think of anything that might explain this attack, would you please get in touch with us immediately?
I remember everything about it. It was school sports day. Kay, Louise and I were only spectators, so we slipped away and went down to the beach. By the time we thought about going home, it was late. There wasn't a bus in sight. And then this rather nice-looking man pulled up in his car and offered us a lift straight to our suburb. Well, there were three of us. We thought, you know, safety in numbers. So we got into the car.
Of course. 10 years ago, three schoolgirls.
It was all over the newspapers for weeks.
Just after I'd been promoted, I was hoping to work on the case. Everybody was talking about it. Philip Stedman.
Philip Stedman.
Abducted three girls and held them in a mountain shed overnight.
Seemed like forever. It was a nightmare. Anyway, he got away before they finally found us.
Mrs. Carter, can you remember if Stedman took any of your clothing with him?
Must tears our school stockings. He was caught, and we all had to testify against him in court. On the way out, he told someone that he'd kill us all one day.
Here is a news flash from the Herald Sun newsroom. There are unconfirmed reports that the two escapees, John Alfred Nielsen and Barry Michael Stevens, have been sighted in the Riverside area. The police have no comment at this stage, but we understand that roadblocks have been set up and police leave has been cancelled. It's not known if the escapees are armed, but police describe them as dangerous.
I missed you, Barry. I missed you. Why did you come here? It's dangerous. The police have already been here. And they've got a man outside.
I know, I saw him. But he didn't see me.
Well, he won't be the only one.
Look, it's worth the risk. I had to come. Why didn't you come to see me in prison?
Oh, I wanted to, Barry. But Dad wouldn't let me. He called me writing to you once. And he was angrier than I've ever seen him.
He still hates me. What about Julie?
She's had a pretty hard time. But she does believe what people say about you.
And you?
You know what I think. I haven't changed.
Good.
You're not mine, you know.
Dad.
I'm not your father. You belong to someone she picked up off the streets. Did you know that? I didn't want you to know what I've got to tell you now. Because you're getting like her. You want to go out with men. You want to show your body off in clothes like hers. You're really taking after her, Betty.
I believe in you.
It's in the blood. You can't get away from what's in your blood.
Hi, Greg. Well, hello, Mr. Wilson.
Miss Vernon.
Look, Greg, I'm sorry about that dinner we organized, but it's going to have to wait a while if that's okay.
I'm easy.
I'm finally moving out of that revolting bed sit. Meg's let me move in with her. It'll take a while to get organized.
Well, let me know if there's anything I can do.
Don't worry, I will.
You wish to see one of the prisoners?
Yes, I'm representing a Mrs. Catherine Roberts.
Oh, well, she's showering at the moment. Would you like to wait in the interview room?
All right, fine.
No, you're keeping yourself busy. Don't tell me you've forgotten about Lynn Warner, or don't charity cases get the same attention?
As far as I'm concerned, Miss Vernon, none of my clients has ever had any cause to complain. Have any of yours?
Shut up, Sal. No word of where you were going or what you were going to do. That just astounds me, Lynn. Do you realize the position you put us in?
Look, I thought it'd be all right as long as I got back here on time.
You just didn't think. You've made it so much more difficult for any of the other girls to go on the scheme. Do you realize that? Where did you go?
I went to see Doug's grave.
Oh, heaven's sakes, Lynn. We do not normally allow convicted criminals of armed robbery to go roaming around the countryside. You were given consideration as a very special case, and you've blown it.
I'm sorry.
Okay. So where do we go from here?
Well, I don't suppose they'll give me a second chance. I didn't think so.
They're giving you 1 week suspension. Mr. Butterfield's agreed to take you back. I think he may be taking some of the blame himself, but that's just between you and me, so you're lucky. But if you do it again, I'll personally wring your neck.
What size are you?
Oh, no, thanks. I never wear anything in bed. I don't like rough things against my skin.
No, I know exactly what you mean. I'm all for the velvet touch, Michelle.
Well, you will wear pajamas tonight, Miss Nichols. I mean, supposing there was a fire and you'd got nothing on.
I'd be the first to be rescued.
Get them on.
Oh, I can't wear those. They're men's. They've got got a flap at the front.
Well, get a safety pin and wear them back to front.
Wendy's here.
Hi, Wendy. I'm Christine Mills, the college supervisor. Well, would you like something to eat or anything to drink? Come on, I'm sure you've got a nice voice. Let's hear it.
No, thanks.
Well, if you do, then just let me know, okay?
There's no need to be scared of her. She's okay.
Thanks for the kind words, Amina.
Anytime.
Let's show Wendy where she'll be sleeping.
This way, my doll.
We'll be sharing this room with Amina.
This one's mine. Come on. Here, you can dump your stuff in these two.
Well, I hope you like the room, Wendy.
It's nice. The new houses are nicer.
Thank you, Amina. We'll be having tea soon, so you can meet the rest of the tribe then. I'll let Amina help you unpack, all right? Good girl. I'm in the kitchen, so give me a hoi if you want anything.
Godfrey, you have a rather archaic view of marriage. A wife is more than just a social organizer and a bed warmer.
That's enough.
No. I want you to lean on me. I want to be at your side. I can help you.
How can you?
By sharing in your problems and decisions. Godfrey, like selling the house. We don't have to. I can help you financially.
I don't need your money.
Then why are you selling?
To escape my memories.
Godfrey.
I'm retiring. I can't work anymore. Well, it's time I left the city.
You have a family. Edward has to be educated. He must go to school somewhere.
Well, the boy will have his schooling. You and he will be well provided for with the sale of the house.
Provided for? Godfrey, it's you we need. All the family need you. Robert and the firm.
Oh, it's finished. It's over and done with.
No. Godfrey, I won't let you give up. You can't run away from memories. You have to face them, fight them.
Well, I can't fight anymore. I haven't the strength. It's been too much for me.
Then let me give it to you. Godfrey, the whole world looks black because you've retreated into the darkest corner you could find. You're destroying yourself with despair. Godfrey! No! Godfrey! Did you miss me? Lorelei, don't fail me now.
I must know who you are. Very well. Just wait a moment, please.
Say goodbye to you. That's all.
All right. All right, I'll see you there.
Don't tell anyone else. No one.
No, I won't, I promise. Thank you, Mr. Phillips. That was Gary Brown, wasn't it? Oh, it was just a private call. Sit down. I said sit down, Melissa. I told her I don't know anything about Gary.
But you know who we are.
I'm not telling you anything.
You know who I am, don't you?
No.
We're very special policemen.
We're from the homicide squad, Belinda.
You know that policeman who was here a while ago? There wasn't anything wrong, was there?
No. Just routine.
It was just that he came into the house before he left and started asking me questions about you.
What about?
Oh, what hours you keep, things like that. He wanted to know your exact movements last night.
Oh, not you, Blake, said Ken. I've just about had enough of this.
Won't keep you long, Sam. We just picked up a bloke for burglary. Thought you might know him.
Why should he?
He lived in the next street, Mrs. Hudson. Quite a coincidence, isn't it? Name's Swan, Gary Swan. Any connection with you, Sam?
Swan? Ever heard of him?
Quite certain?
Of course.
What about you, Mrs. Hudson?
Well, no.
You don't seem too sure.
Oh, I'm quite sure, Mr. Johnson. There's not many people in the neighborhood I do know, really, and I never had any children to play with others or anything like that.
All right. You know, Sam, I'd hate to think our relations were ever less than cordial.
Oh, so would I, Jeff. So would I.
Mike.
Yeah. Thanks, Emma.
Why, Sam? Why wouldn't you tell them?
Oh, don't worry about it.
I lied too, Sam, and I don't like doing that. But I'm prepared to believe you had good reason.
Okay, Emma. You've seen Johnson. You know what he's like. If I'd said I know Gary, it'd only make things worse.
What if the police find out? What if Gary tells them?
Well, I don't think he will. But even if he does, he's just a nice kid who does deliveries, isn't he?
I suppose so. But I'd feel easier if we'd both told the truth.
Mrs. Hudson, we believe that Sam might have been involved in the burglary on Poplar Avenue the night before last.
The night before last? But he was at the Trots.
Yes, I know, that's his story, but he can't prove it.
But I'm sure he was. He goes every week. Wait on. I think I remember throwing out a tote ticket that he dropped in this waste paper basket here. They're dated, aren't they?
Yes, but I don't think that would prove anything.
But add weight to his story.
Might.
Then I'll just go and have a search through the rubbish bins. They haven't been emptied since.
You're determined to help him, aren't you?
Yes, Miss Frances. I am.
Is everything all right at home, Lorraine? Daddy was there. Well, you're so different. I imagine we'd have hundreds of things to talk about, but all the way from the prison, you've hardly said a word to me.
Well, look, there is something.
Ron doesn't want me to come and stay with you, does he?
No, Mum, it's not Ron. I don't want you. Oh, look, there's no point in beating about the bush. I've done a lot of thinking these last few years. Ron's done very well at his job, and the children... Well, Judith Ann goes to ballet, and Andrew has his cubs.
What has all this to do with me, Lou?
Everything. I couldn't stand my friends to find out about you. I will not have my family pay for a mistake you made.
I paid for that mistake, Lorraine.
Yes. Well, you can't come and stay with us, and that's all there is to it.
I see.
You can call me a bitch if you like. Ron's as good as done that.
Yes, you let me believe I had a room at your home. Why?
Right. I didn't think I'd ever let you out.
You hoped I'd die.
Yes. You know, I've never really forgiven you for what you've done. When we moved to the new district, I tried to forget all about you. I want to make a clean break, Mum. Well, at least I'm being honest.
I always wondered what being honest meant.
I'll arrange a room for you somewhere, and Ron will be in touch with you about some financial details.
Could we leave now, please?
Open the boot, Lorraine.
What do you want?
Open it.
What are you doing?
I'll catch a bus.
Don't be stupid. I said I'd drive you into town and arrange a room for you.
I'll find my own.
But I can't just drive away and leave you out here.
Not.
Because you're my mother.
You have no mother, Lorraine. She died in there a few minutes ago. I just
just get in your car and drive back to your family.
Louise Carter?
Yes.
I'm Jane Sloan.
My mother's sister?
Yes.
Then you're my aunt?
Yes.
Oh, it's so good of you to come and meet me.
I'll be honest with you, I'm not happy about this meeting.
It appears I'm the only one who is.
The past is past. Best to leave it like that.
But it was my mother's decision to meet me. Shall we go? I have no other luggage.
I didn't expect you would. It's not as if you'd be staying. You get out here while I put the car in the garage.
I'd be grateful for any information.
Well, as I said, Margaret was very young when she got pregnant. She wasn't married. The pregnancy caused a scandal in the village.
Jane, who was my father?
His name was Bill. Billy Turner. He did odd jobs about the place. He was a drifter. There were plenty of those around after the war. I never knew what Margaret saw in him. Father sent him away.
Did my father try and make contact at all?
Of course not. We heard later that he died, a car accident or something. He was living in Hobart. I'm sure everything would have been all right if only that stupid nurse at the hospital hadn't shown Margaret the baby. Irresponsible woman. Had a terrible effect on her. Suddenly she didn't want to give you away. She had a nervous breakdown. For 5 years she was in and out of that nursing home. My father was inconsolable. And I never married. There never seemed the opportunity, nor very much free time.
I don't think you understand my side of it.
If you'll forgive me saying so, Louise, I don't care about your side of it. I only care about Margaret and the effect all this will have on her. I think you should return to the mainland as soon as possible.
Yes, I'd plan to go back tomorrow.
What about tonight?
Well, I was rather hoping I could stay here with my family.
That's not possible, I'm afraid. Naturally, you can have dinner with us, but after that, you must go.
I'll do whatever my mother wants.
Well, I hope you enjoyed wasting your time last night.
Oh, I didn't think it was a waste of time. I quite enjoyed it.
Yes, come to think of it, you'd have an affinity with the working class, with your background.
What do you know about my background?
Oh, enough to know you came from the wrong side of the tracks.
Exactly where you'll end up when I'm finished.
Not a chance.
We'll see. I'm going to make your life such hell you'll be glad to walk out of here.
If I do, Stephen will come with me.
Stephen will stay where the money is.
He might have it himself by then.
Never. I'm going to keep Stephen and my money, and you can be darn sure I'm going to get rid of you. Quick. My pills. Handbag. Patricia. Please.
Well, the important thing is that she gets plenty of rest.
Make quite sure of that.
And keeps warm and calm. And plenty of fluids, fruit juice, cups of tea, that sort of thing.
She'll be well looked after, Doctor.
Yes, I'm sure she will. You're very lucky to have Thelma, otherwise you'd probably still be in hospital.
Oh, I'm so glad to be home, Doctor.
Right. Now, these are the capsules. 2-3 times a day, about an hour before meals, if possible. Look, I'll leave you in charge of the medication, Thelma. I'll drop in every day, but ring me at the clinic if there's any problems. Now, are you sure you'll be able to manage?
Of course I will, Doctor. I've been looking forward to it. She's done so many things for me in my life, Doctor. I owe her so much. You couldn't imagine how much I've been looking forward to repaying her.
Here you are, dear. I've made you a nice cup of dandelion tea.
Oh, thanks, Thelma.
And it's time for your pills. You ought to take two, he said.
Thelma?
Yes, dear?
Thelma, I'm sorry about the budgie.
What's done is done. No sense going over it. Take your pills.
Well, I was just angry, you see, and well, he was noisy.
I never found him to be. Now, take a sip of tea to wash down your pills. And don't worry. It's all over now. Nothing to worry about anymore. You needn't worry ever again. I'll look after you. Now, drink your tea. It'll do you the world of good. You mustn't drink that tea.
Why not?
No more tea, ever.
What's the matter? Oh, no, what's wrong?
I didn't mean to make you sick. Not really sick, anyway.
What?
I only wanted you to see what it's like to be dependent on someone.
I don't understand.
Ellie, I've been putting something in your tea. Could have killed you.
Killed me?
It was a horrible thing to do. I hate myself. I feel so guilty. Don't you hate me?
No. No, I don't.
I only wanted to show you what it was like. Oh, I didn't mean to harm you. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Aunt tells me you've been to Europe.
Oh, I often am, my dear.
No, I meant to Switzerland to ski.
Ah, yes, St. Moritz. Gorgeous spot. Have you ever skied there?
No, I've barely seen snow.
Next vacation, I'll take you skiing.
Oh, I'd love to learn.
A pity you haven't had the opportunity before.
Nothing to it, Jane. All it takes is balance, strong knees.
So, your ski job?
Oh, yeah. Be on the boat.
And have you travelled much?
Only to America when I was modelling for Reflections.
Ah, yes. But your family lives abroad?
Yes, in Hong Kong.
Oh, don't they find it terribly overcrowded these days? It was such a lovely city before the war. So colonial.
My mum lives in Pommyland.
Indeed. Visiting family, perhaps? I'm acquainted with a number of county families.
Well, they're staying with a Mr. Worthington's daughter in St. Albans.
Oh, I can't say I'm familiar with the area.
Oh, this looks nice. What's this called?
Vichyssoise.
Oh, yeah? Looks just like soup.
Well, bon appetit.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Please don't upset yourself, my dear. Richard, a cloth, please.
What's a little wine between friends?
Oh, as full as a butcher's pup. My compliments to the cook.
Oh, thank you, Joe. I'll pass them along.
Look, I hate to eat and run. I've got to take over from a babysitter.
Oh, what a shame, just when we were getting along so nicely.
Thanks for coming, Joe.
Ah, wouldn't have missed it for quids, mate. I don't suppose your bloke could drop me home, could he?
Of course. Richard, would you drive Mr. Mangle home, please?
Certainly, ma'am.
See you later, then.
See you, Joe.
Thank you very much. Thank you. You mind if I drive, mate?
You wait till Jean tells you about her plans for the wedding, ma'am.
Yes, it's going to be a small wedding, just the family and friends. It's a beautiful church. We're going to fill it with flowers. Bronwyn and Gail, my bridesmaids, will be in tones of yellow.
I'm sure it'll be lovely, dear. When did you say you'd be returning from the honeymoon?
About mid-March.
Oh, good. The West Wing redecorations will be completed by then.
Sorry, I don't understand.
We haven't exactly got around to talking about our living arrangements yet, Mom. You should see the house. It's on Long Island. Knockout views.
I thought we'd just be getting a flat in the city.
Oh, no, dear. The Grangers have always lived at Longview. I'm already engaging extra staff, but it's probably best if you choose your own maid.
Do you really think I'll need a maid?
Oh, it's not a matter of need.
It'll just make life a little bit easier.
It really is a different world, isn't it?
I hope you won't find it too difficult to make the adjustment.
You'll get the hang of it, Jane.
Yeah. In a couple of months, I'll be wondering how I ever got along without a maid.
You took your time.
Oh, well, we got here as quick as we could, Betty.
What if the burglar had been here when I got back? I could have been lying dead on the floor by now.
Got back from where? Not the community centre, by any chance?
Community centre?
Yeah, weren't you doing your Know Your Antiques course?
No. The only antique round here is me, and getting more antique by the minute. Now, can we get on with this so that you can catch whoever stole my PlayStation?
Right.
They also took some jewellery and a radio, but I need the PlayStation for the weekend. Otherwise, the kids will be climbing up the wall.
You will show us how the thieves got in, please.
Yes, certainly. Can I get you a cup of tea, Jack?
Hi, thanks, Betty.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good. Bye.
Bye now, mate. It's got to be one off.
Well, it's the same as the other two Bergs.